Hi. By now, we're all used to this new normal. I am growing my quarantine beard. Your schedule is filled with video hangouts, if it's anything like mine, and the streets around the world are empty. COVID-19 has changed everything about how we live our lives. And I don't know about you, but I never really thought much about disinfecting things like around the house, but now I think about it all the time. And in doing so, I started to look at my laundry machine, that little guy in the corner of the basement, differently. Laundry machines are dark, moist, and warm, three things that microorganisms love. Bacteria biofilms have been known to build up in washing machines. It's gross, but it's a thing that happens. We don't know much about them. More research is definitely needed there. So let me air our collective dirty laundry here. Your laundry machine is probably gross. You can and maybe should disinfect your laundry. You can and probably should clean your laundry machine sometimes. And you probably are being safe already, but now you'll have some peace of mind to rely on too. So let's kick them when they're up, kick them when they're down, and kick into it, Don Henley. Hi there, I am Trace, science communicator, curiosity explorer, and professional nerd person. But launderer? That's something that I also learned to do at a young age, and hopefully you have too. We shared a laundry machine with five people and two cats when I was a kid, which means also we likely shared bacteria. Like, a lot of it. Humans are covered in microorganisms. Most of the stuff that lives on human skin is either good for you or like chaotic neutral at best. But occasionally we encounter something that's stinky or moldy or downright dangerous, like we did right now. And this is why laundry can be used as a protective force for your home. It keeps pathogens out of your house. And now that we're used to being in the house all the time, we've got these systems in place to help us cope, hopefully, and to keep us safe. Laundry can be one of those, but only if you're doing it correctly. I'm gonna talk about how your laundry machine might be gross. Like, hint, possibly, like, really gross. Before we go any further, though, let me say this clearly and slowly for the Facebook crowd out there. If you are a normal human being following the physical distancing protocols laid out by literally every rational government on this planet, chances are you are not going to contact a new virus today. That said, if you're not part of that crowd, you should know that you can get sick and not know it. Your illness can be spread to others without you ever showing symptoms, and that includes children, seniors, and people who are immunocompromised. You could make someone sick who could save someone else's life. So stay home. All of that aside, COVID-19 probably will not and cannot infect you from normal everyday laundry. And COVID-19 probably cannot and will not infect you from other people's laundry. But viruses can live inside washing machines. Microorganisms can live on surfaces in laundromats or in apartment laundry rooms. Microorganisms and viruses can live on towels, bed sheets, and other stuff in your home. And yes, they can also survive a trip through the dishwasher, the laundry machine. Whether they will infect you from that is a whole other thing. And I can feel you itching right now, and I'm right there with you. So let's dive into this laundry excitement and start with the superstar of laundry, the hospital. Hospitals have lots of fabrics to keep clean. Hospital beds have sheets and blankets. Nurses and doctors wear uniforms, scrubs, and coats. Those fabrics keep the droplets of cough, sneeze, and spittle spewed by other humans from entering our bodies, but they can also catch those droplets and cling to them. Hospital-acquired infections are real, which means so are laundry practices at hospitals. Hospitals use a combination of heat, chemistry, and physical attacks to kill microbes. The CDC recommends hospital sheets be washed at least 71 Celsius for 25 minutes to destroy microorganisms, and to do that may require a steam jet or a booster heater, and then once that's done, they douse the whole load in chlorine bleach, and then they use a mild acid or sour to shift the pH of the water really fast and further ensure pathogens are completely destroyed. Together, these processes make sure that hospital fabrics are not just clean, but they're also disinfected. That pH adjustment at the end can also reduce skin reactions to laundry. How thoughtful. If your home washer seems a bit paltry by comparison to this, that's because it probably is. But we won't really come into contact with pathogens on a daily basis unless you work in healthcare. Really quick, shout out to healthcare workers. Thank you for everything that you're doing. Nurses, doctors, EMTs, the person who works the front desk, you are all putting yourselves in harm's way. The guy who cleans the floor, the gal who cleans the toilets, everyone who works in a hospital right now deserves our respect and our care. Thank you. The first thing about laundry is that it's like Hogwarts. It's all about the sorting. Normally we have three piles, right? You got your clean pile, you got your dirty pile, and you got those jeans that you wore on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, you put on your floor last night, and you're gonna wear them tomorrow again. And that is totally fine. You can keep that system, I'm not here to judge, but the CDC recommends that there be a whole new level above that pile. Separate your wardrobe into inside clothes and outside clothes. Outside clothes are the ones that you wear to the grocery store, to the alcohol store, to the pharmacy, or to work in healthcare or food service or other essential businesses that are still open right now. Outside clothes should not be washed with inside clothes. Think of them as contaminated. Keep the outside clothes outside in a bag that's open enough that the clothes can dry. In the sun, that's even better. The heat and the dryness will kill any pathogens on them. See, COVID-19 physically lives in moisture droplets that come out of bodies through coughing or sneezing or whatever. You remove that moisture and it will die. So don't mix your outsides with your insides, even for laundry. Laundry machines will clean, but they don't disinfect. Plus, they're warm and wet, both things that microorganisms and viruses love. So instead, once you've got enough clothes to wash from the outside pile, gather them up. Now might be a good time to wear those latex gloves that you keep around, you know, for reasons. But if you don't have any cuts or scrapes on your hands, bare hands are better because you remember to wash them. Wash them before, wash them after, wash them during. You can even think about getting a disposable liner for your hamper if that's your thing. Remove the outside clothes from the hamper, but before you put them in the laundry machine, do not shake them open. I know I do this all the time. Don't do that because it can throw little bits of pathogens into the air, which makes the whole area contaminated. Once you've tossed the outside clothes into the washer, use the warmest setting for those clothes. Not because hot water is gonna scald the pathogens to death. I know that we are all guilty of thinking, hot water, yeah, it's gonna kill it. But that's not really what it is. It's instead to make sure that the detergent is activated. Once that happens, the soap will clean the microorganisms off of the clothing and wash them away. Soap makes water wetter, literally. It makes things less sticky in the water, allowing the water to access the nooks, crannies in the clothing. Sidebar. Do not use extra soap. More soap, more better is not the mantra here. Too much soap actually makes more soap suds, and suds are a great place for pathogens to hide and ride out the laundry cycle. Another thing to note is that there are no real standards when it comes to home laundry. Hot water is less hot now than it used to be. If you follow the government guidelines, your hot water heater at home is probably about 50 Celsius or 120 Fahrenheit, but that's still gonna vary from place to place. And remember, the hospital, they use hot steam jets. And you don't have that at home, but that's okay. Just be smart. While the outside clothes are washing in your machine, disinfect any surfaces that you may have set those clothes on. And while you're at it, go ahead and disinfect the inside of the basket, dispose of the liner if you have one, or clean the hamper. If you're at a laundromat, just bring wipes with you. It's really unlikely that there will be enough virus on the clothing or on those surfaces to get you, but we're being thorough here. After your wash is done, take the clothing and put it in the dryer on the highest setting available for those clothes. Do not wear outside clothes that you cannot dry in the dryer, because the dryer is actually the superpower of personal pathogenic pugilism. The hot air in the dryer will remove all the moisture from the clothing and reduce bacterial load. No moisture equals no pathogens. Something like a virus will get desiccated, a fancy word meaning extra dried out or dead. You should honestly be more worried about fecal bacteria in home laundry than you should about COVID-19, but the main thing to remember is dry, dry, dry for more than 28 minutes at least. Even low heat is better than no heat. At that point, voila, you've got washed and mostly sanitized laundry clothing. That stuff can go back in the closet until you run out of wine and you need to go outside again because that is really serious. You can't just live without wine. They haven't done it since ancient times. Why should we start now? Washers are not magic. They're basically a big soapy cappuccino of detergent and water and whatever grime cells, bacteria, and viruses were on your clothes. Which is why, once you've washed your outside pile in your washer, you might be worried about being infected by other things that are still in there. And there is a super slim possibility of passing the rinsed off pathogens onto clothes that you put in. Or if you share a machine, passing them onto someone else or getting them from someone else. An Australian study found a 90% reduction in pathogens in regular laundry. 90%, pretty good. 99% when using chlorine or activated oxygen bleach. So if you're really worried, like if you've come in contact with a potential virus or you're not sure about your shared laundry situation, bleach's active ingredient is sodium hypochlorite. It kills bacteria, fungi, and viruses, and it shouldn't be used willy-nilly. It can be rendered ineffective if you use it wrong, and don't mix it with ammonia because it will create a poisonous gas that could kill you. That may have happened in Boy Scouts when I was younger. Look, if you're separating your outside pile and washing and drying it separately, you're probably fine. But if you're really concerned, maybe wash the whites first with a little sanitizing bleach. In the end, if you let your outside clothes dry first before you wash them, you're gonna kill the pathogens. Then if you wash them and dry them again, you're doing that double duty. If you don't have a dryer, the sun can work, UV radiation may help, but you need to expose all the surfaces of your clothing directly to see any benefit, and you'd probably have to do some research into the humidity levels of your area and how that affects viruses. It's better just to use a dryer if you have one and dry it. Dry it. Though there is a small risk of catching a disease from a laundered clothing machine, you're far more likely to catch something from a surface nearby. So if you go to a laundromat, wipe down your surfaces, and if you're still worried, you can always clean your laundry machine or ask the laundromat owner when they last cleaned theirs. Look, this coronavirus is not going anywhere anytime soon. We're gonna have to hunker down and weather this storm. But that doesn't mean that we should stem our interest in the world outside. With CuriosityStream, you can learn a little bit about everything. If you want to understand the coronavirus, they have something on that. You want to not think about that and just think about nature, they got lots of stuff on that, including a show called Nature's Mathematics. You want to know how the internet changed the world? Derek and CuriosityStream has got you, fam. CuriosityStream has thousands of documentaries on interesting and thoughtful topics across science and history, the environment, technology, society, psychology, you name it, they got it. Join CuriosityStream with my link, curiositystream.com/trace. Use the promo code trace and you're going to get 1 month for free to try this out. And if that's all you want, cool. But it's only $2.99 a month after that. And if you pick up an annual subscription, which is even more affordable, you will get Nebula for free as a bonus. Nebula is a service that I helped start with a bunch of other creators. We own it, and it's a place where we can do thoughtful experiments and play with our formats, create our own originals, and of course air our own episodes all direct to you without worrying about algorithms. CuriosityStream believes in this mission too and was like, we want in. So right now, if you join CuriosityStream with the annual subscription, you're gonna get Nebula too. And with this deal, you get tons of documentaries and shows with CuriosityStream, plus you get Nebula with all our projects and originals and series and shows too. Just try it out at curiositystream.com/trace, use the promo code trace, and it tells them that I sent you there, which supports me. And if you opt in at the annual rate, you'll get Nebula for free too. And if it's faux free, it's faux me. Thanks. At the end of the day, the biggest worry isn't getting coronaviruses from your arm onto your arm skin. It's getting a large load of COVID-19 onto your hands. Once there, it can get on all sorts of things. So wash your hands, avoid touching your face, thank people who are staying indoors, and clap when you see a nurse or a doctor or an EMT. These humans are looking out for others every day and putting themselves in harm's way, and that selflessness is just the best. Viruses do not care how friendly you are, who you vote for, how many followers saw your Insta story. They infect humans dispassionately, and you can carry COVID-19 for weeks without knowing it, and accidentally infect someone who can go on to infect someone else. And if that happens, we could be inside for who knows how long, and nobody wants that. And really, these days there are far worse things to think about than being a microorganism metropolis, like that you and everyone in your house loses 500 million skin cells every day. Yeah. Like every few weeks we shed our entire outermost layer of skin. Everyone in your house is doing that all the time. Yikes-a-roo, right? How many skins are laying around your house right now? Gross! Awesome! Oh, so cool. Anyway, thanks for watching Uno Dose of Trace. Keep your hands clean, and I will see you outside, hopefully, in the future.